Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Well, this is the first recording on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph, powered by the Edison Econowatt motor. So I just wanted to do a quick recording. This is still a pretty rough configuration, but the machine's actually running quite stable considering how it's piecemealed together. Now tomorrow I'll be getting a proper belt. I'll tie the bed plate down. I may just screw it down to the workbench for right now. I just have to do some experiments before I put a lot of time into it as far as building an enclosure or mounting it. So I've got to put it through its paces, do some recordings, see how stable it is, see how it runs. This motor hadn't run in probably 80 years, and so it's going to take a day or so to figure out exactly what I'm going to do. I have to get a belt for it, still running on the duct tape belt. And the bed plate is still just sitting on the workbench. I have a nail through one of the screw holes on the bed plate to keep the belt tensioned. But other than that, the bed plate is just sitting there. So as I said, it's a pretty rough configuration, but it's a real good way to do some initial testing to see what it's going to take to power this phonograph with an electric motor. So just want to do a quick recording. In fact, this is the very first recording on the Edison Home B powered by the Econowatt motor. So just want to do a quick video. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Answer all of my email. Try to answer the day I get it. But again, just a quick video on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph powered by an Edison Econowatt electric motor. So again, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.